on guys, I'm back with another video. Today I am back on Bethlehem, and in today's video I'll showcase a bunch of new things that have been added to Bethlehem over the last couple of updates, because of course it has been a really long time since my last video on here. Anyways, before we get into showcasing the new cool custom content, I just want to announce a juicy giveaway of two of these Wolfman boxes. So there will be two different winners winning one of these boxes each. All you have to do to enter the giveaway is make sure you are subscribed, make sure to turn on notifications, make sure to like the video and comment your in-game name down below. The winners will be picked in just about 2 days. As always, they will be announced in my community Discord, in the server's Discord, and on my pinned comment. Links of Discord are down below in the description, so definitely make sure to join those. Anyways, I have one of these boxes in here. I already went over the mounting itself in a different video, so check that out if you haven't already. But basically, from this box, you get the full shaman set together with this wolf head totem and, of course, the wolf pet, or the blood wolf pet rather. And then if you equip this full set, you'll be able to mount your wolf and ride on him. I'm quickly going to show how the wolf actually works with the mount. I already have a full video on this. Once again, if you guys want to check that out, go ahead and do so. But quickly, if you equip the full set and you have your mount out, or your wolf, you have this option right here, which is the mount version. And if you are in the mount version, you will deal a constant amount of damage that your wolf will put out. So that is super nice. You also have the Emperor Dragon mount, which also looks super sick if you can get your hands on that. So starting off to the Titans, they added these three new Game of Thrones, part 1, 2 and 3 of course. So clicking on part 1, which is of course the first one you will have to go to, pretty much what you have in here is a zone full of NPCs. Whenever you kill these NPCs, you get points, and then you can spend those points right here at the Lord Commander to buy yourself some Dragon Slayer armor set, or the Long Claw, and of course the regular Long Claw. These Long Claws are the ones that you will need in order to go ahead and go to the second part of the Game of Thrones. The only thing is though, you can't bring any equipment, I believe. So whenever you have banked all your equipment and you only have the Long Claw, you will be able to teleport to the part 2. In order to go ahead and do the part 2, as you can see, which is only one boss, the Eternal Dragon, you will have this Long Claw, and then of course you will have the equipment that you are allowed to bring. This will drop the Eternal Dragon Pet and also the Ice Jewel, which I believe is the item required to go to part 3. Now for part 3, as you can see, you can get the Eternal Companion and also the Inferno Jewel, as you can see right there. You have to kill this Kel America, which is of course, I believe, a character from Game of Thrones. It might be a shame, but I haven't seen Game of Thrones itself, actually, never, like, so this is all new for me. But anyways, this is the part 3 boss that you'll have to go ahead and kill in order to get some of those juicy drops. Also, if you haven't noticed yet, I have been running around with this YouTuber set, which is also a new set that they have added in game. This is pretty much a cosmetic set, however, it does look quite dope if you ask me. And it also states that you are a YouTuber or a content creator for the server, which I think is really nice because people will notice you and maybe check out your channel a little bit more. Now they have also added a wiki for Bethlehem, which will make this server a lot easier, especially for new players who are brand new to this custom server. This will help you out to get through all the custom tiers, etc. So you have a starting out quick link right here. You have the prices and drop rates, the monsters, the item list, donated perks, miscellaneous, and also combat and perks. I believe these are just some quick links to get to there. For example, then you'll have some more links, etc., which will help you out in the long run. So if you need any help around Bethlehem, just make sure to type colon wiki in game, and that will directly take you to this page where you have all the information about Bethlehem. Also about the wiki, if you need some information about a certain item, for example the Long Claw, you can type colon search and then type Long Claw just like that, and it will automatically open up the wiki page about the Long Claw. Also, I haven't showed you guys the Dragon Slayer set yet that you can get from the first part of Game of Thrones. Basically, this is the full set and what it looks like. It looks absolutely amazing if you ask me, especially the Long Claw with the eye, which is the imbued version, I believe. It looks a lot better than the regular one if you ask me. However, the regular one also looks super cool. It looks very clean. So another set I want to showcase is the Kylo Ren set. Now you have multiple ways of getting this, of course buying it from other players. You can also get the cape and the boots, I believe, as a drop from the actual Star Wars minigame, which I'm going to show you guys in just a second. And then of course the three other pieces, so the legs, the body and the helmet, have to be invented, which I'll also show in just a second. Starting off, I want to showcase the minigame of Star Wars. If you go to the minigame teleport, you will have a bunch of minigames that you can go ahead and check out. But we're going to start with the Star Wars minigame because, of course, this is where you can get yourself the Star Wars set and also the Kylo Ren cape and gloves. And you will need the Star Wars set in order to go ahead and get the gloves, to get the Kylo Ren set, rather, my bad. Pretty much to go through this, you will have to get these keys. Each NPC here drops one of the keys and then you'll be able to move on to the next part. I already have all four keys, so I'm going to skip this real quick. Go to the final boss. Here you have the Darth Vader, which you actually can go ahead and kill. And the Darth Vader is the one that will give you the Star Wars chest keys. Now you can use these keys on the chest right here at the end. The boss chest, I don't know if you can check out the drops when you examine them. Don't think so, however. If you go ahead and loot this chest, you'll see that you can get yourself the Darth Vader armor set, the Kylo Ren cape, gloves, also a Darth Saber, and then some of these others. So let's go ahead and open some of these. Let's see if we can get ourselves lucky and get a legendary reward. But so far, I'm only getting rares and commons, which isn't really nice. Some space dust, some more cash. I mean, I can't complain about the cash and the space dust, but I would have rather gotten a rare drop to showcase to you guys. And once you have the Darth Vader set, you have two options. You can type invent, or you can go to the upgrade machine right here and go to invent right there. There are a bunch of items that you can already go ahead and invent, but if we are going to check out the Kylo Ren, as you can see, for the helmet, you will need the Darth Vader helmet eye, plus 20 space dust, plus 5 of these Valerian steel bars in order to upgrade it into the Kylo Ren set. Same goes for the body and also for the legs. You just need a little bit more space dust, I believe, for the body and the legs. However, if the set is completed, this is what it looks like, and it looks absolutely amazing if you ask me. I love that it's so black and so saturated black. These are the stats about, let me just go ahead and remove this real quick. This is the set, this is the full set. And actually, this set has no stats, but it gives you a 2000 HP boost, which is really nice. However, this means that you can still be one hit by Titans whenever you have this on. The HP buff also allows you to use Soul Split without conflicting with the effect, which is super nice. So if you have Soul Split, you basically have a constant 2000 HP boost. If you combine that with some really high defense ring, amulet, and whatever it is, boots, I believe, then you are pretty set to go. Anyways, moving on, they added some really cool content for Iron Man. So this is a new Iron Man zone. They actually teleported me in here because, of course, I am not an Iron Man rank on this account. But pretty much you have the Iron Man chest right here, which I think is like a chest that you can open as an Iron Man with an Iron Man key. And you can get yourself some skilling supplies. You can also get a herb pouch, charm box, and also this drop rate potion. But you can also get the collector's amulet and the imbued version of the collector's amulet from this chest. I believe if we check out the NPCs around here, they will drop these keys. Plus also, as you can see right there, is a key. Plus also a bunch of other really cool drops. For example, this is thermonuclear smoke devil. And if we run around the zone, you still have a bunch of other NPCs, I believe, that you can go ahead and kill. For example, these, which will drop... I don't know what these drop actually. These drop the scroll of efficiencies and mystery boxes. You have some implings that you can go ahead and catch. Let me run around the zone real quick. Some more implings right there. And I believe that is about it for the Iron Man zone. Actually, right here at the end, you can still buy yourself some supplies for summoning, which is also really nice. So you also have an upgraded version or an imbued version of the Dragon Slayer armor set, which is of course the Slayer set with the eye at the end. So this is basically the full set. You need 35 Valorian steel bars in order to go ahead and make this set together with the Icy Maul of Omens. If you have those, I believe you use them on an anvil in order to upgrade the armor set into this, which also looks super nice. Now, this has a total of a 25% drop rate and double drop rate bonus, which make this set really cool. Also, this set is not tradable, so once you get it, you'll be with this set forever because you can't sell it to other players. Actually, you have this Lava Forge right here where you can go ahead and upgrade the Dragon Armor set or the Dragon Slayer Armor set, which is in the wilderness though, so you do have to watch out for precarious whenever you try to do this. But anyways, that is what I will be ending off today's video, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure to smash the like button and make sure to subscribe if you didn't already. Also, make sure to enter the giveaway and make sure to check out all of these updates on Bethlehem itself because they have a bunch of amazing content and I want all of you guys to check it out. But with all that said, this is what I will be ending off the video, so I'll be catching you guys in my next video. Peace.